My dear friends, welcome to Rajasekhar classes on formal languages and automata theory. This is lecture number 71. Design PDA means push down automata for balanced parentheses, or design PDA for well formed parentheses. First, we will try to understand what is well formed parentheses. This is an example of well formed parentheses. Why? Because you have one left parentheses, again its corresponding right parentheses. In similar manner, this one is also a well formed parentheses or balanced parentheses. You have one left parentheses and its corresponding right parentheses. We have one left parentheses and its corresponding right parentheses. There is another example. This is also well formed parentheses, left parentheses, right parentheses, left parentheses, right parentheses, isn't it? Again, this one is also well formed parentheses or balanced parentheses. Left parentheses, right parentheses, left parentheses, right parentheses, left parentheses, right parentheses, left parentheses, right parentheses. Another example. Yes. Now, what about this one? This one is also well formed parentheses, one left parentheses, left, right. This is also balanced parentheses or well formed parentheses. Now, this is not balanced parentheses. Why? Because you have left parentheses, but there is no corresponding right parentheses. This is also not well formed parentheses. You have left parentheses, you have corresponding right parentheses. But problem here is you don't have right parentheses corresponding to this particular left parentheses. Therefore, it's not balanced parentheses. You can understand from this slide, these are the examples for balanced parentheses. These are not examples of balanced parentheses. Now, we will try to understand this problem is similar to PDA. In which equal number of A's is equal to number of B's. What is the logic? If you come across A's, you have to push into the stack. If you come across B's, you have to pop into the stack. If there are equal number of A's and B's, ultimately stack will get emptied. Therefore, I can say that particular automata accepts that equal number of A's and B's. It is similar one. Just what happens here, just see, if I get some left parentheses, I must push into the stack. If I get left parentheses, in top of the stack is also left parentheses, I must push. If I get right parentheses and top of the stack is left parentheses, pop. If I get right parentheses, if I get left parentheses and right parentheses, here you have right parentheses, left parentheses, even left parentheses, right parentheses also, you can remove from top of the stack. Isn't it? If you get left parentheses, top of the stack is Z0, just simply push into the stack. Imitate that this equal number of A's and B's lecture. You can understand this one. It is simple and straightforward. Let me take one sample string and explain. Let me consider this one. This one is input tape in which you have left parentheses, right parentheses, left, right, left, right. Now we will try to understand this concept. Now, what is the state? Let me assume Q0 is my initial state. Q0 is a state and left parentheses is input. Q0 on left parentheses, top of the stack is Z0. What you have to do, you have to push left parentheses onto the stack. Let me say I pushed into the stack. Now, where we are, I am in Q1 state. Let me say now I am in Q1 state. Now, what is left parentheses? Q1 on left parentheses, just see Q1 on left parentheses, Q1 on left parentheses, top of the stack is also left parentheses. Q1 on left parentheses, top of the stack is also left parentheses. What you have to do? Just push that left parentheses onto the stack. Now this one is completed. Now Q1 on right parentheses, top of the stack is left parentheses. Q1 on right parentheses, top of the stack is left parentheses. What you have to do? You have to remove this one. Just I am removing and staying in the same state. Now let me read again left parentheses. It's a right parentheses. Q1 on right parentheses, top of the stack is left parentheses. Q1 on right parentheses, top of the stack is left parentheses means epsilon means I must remove this one and I must go here. Again Q1 left parentheses, top of the stack is Z0. Q1 left parenthesis, top of the stack is Z naught, means I must push into the stack, isn't it? And Q1 on right parenthesis, top of the stack is left parenthesis. Q1 on right parenthesis, top of the stack is left parenthesis, means epsilon, means I must remove this one and staying in the same state. A and Q1 on left parenthesis, Q1 on left parenthesis, top of the stack is Z naught. If top of the stack is Z naught, Q1 on left parenthesis, Q1 on left parenthesis, just push into the stack. Again, Q1 on right parenthesis and top of the stack is left parenthesis, Q1 on right parenthesis, where we are, Q1 on right parenthesis, top of the stack is top of the stack is left parenthesis, Q1 on right parenthesis, top of the stack is empty it. Empty it means what? Just remove these things. Q1 on epsilon and top of the stack is Z naught, therefore QF. QF means what? Final state. Therefore, I can say this is a pushdown automata which can accept balanced parenthesis. Now, again, just consider this one, design PDA. PDA means what? PDA means pushdown automata that accepts strings of well-formed parentheses or balanced parentheses. Consider, in this case, consider parentheses, there may be left parentheses, left square bracket, left power brackets, right parentheses, right square bracket, right square bracket. Just imitate a previous problem. It's simple. Left, if there is a left parenthesis, push into the stack. If this left square bracket, push into the stack. If top of the symbol, in these three cases, top of the single is top of the stack is Z naught. If left closed floor bracket, just push into the stack. If there's a left parenthesis, again top of the stack is left parenthesis, just push. If a left square bracket, left square, just it's a, just a simile. After reading, once if you read epsilon means that string is completed, in top of the stack is Z naught means just you must go to the where can I go, where can I go, I must say I must reach to the some state. I can say this is final Q1 epsilon Z naught means you must go to the some Q naught Z naught. Q naught Z naught means actually here, just see Q1 epsilon Z means here. I can say this is Q1 epsilon Z naught means this must be a final state. A final state in the sense, just let me rewrite it. Just let me say this is, what is this? QF, isn't it? QF, comma Z naught. Once if I read epsilon, I must say QF Z naught. Now what happens? It is simple and straightforward. How can I say? Just see, just I keep on reading all these things. Once if I read Q1 epsilon Z means, let me say this is QF. QF means what? QF is, it is final state. Just follow the previous rules so that you can understand. Just rewrite it as it's QF. Thank you very much.